On E! True Hollywood Story, we investigate one of Time Magazine's top 25 most controversial physics teachers. It was only recently that reports surfaced, exposing what some may call unique ideals on teaching.
Here is Massac High School, a school in which he's been able to conceal what some have called a questionable approach to education.
Prior to the official interview, we did a background check on the person in question, which revealed some alarming finds. Under the Twitter pseudonym Schmidt Master P, the mysterious secrets of this man's life were revealed. Upon further research, we uncovered what may be the root of his madness. This man was frontman of popular 80s hair metal band Nuts for Squirrels. We uncovered this picture of his time in the spotlight, as well as pictures of his closest and most loyal fans.
Here is a place where it all began, and where it all remains until now. This is the E! True Hollywood Story Investigates, Peter Schmidt.
We first sit down with Johnny Quantum, one of the first students to come forward with his story. Johnny, what made you decide to come forward now?
Well, Mr. Schmidt presented a challenge to me, and being captain of the baseball team, I really thought I could handle it.
And what was that challenge?
He made me fight the bear.
He made you fight a legitimate bear?
No. Worse.
To confront Peter Schmidt about this interview, although he asked for his physical identity to remain a secret.
Not being vague on purpose, when I was teaching the unit on angular momentum, I decided to take a hands-on approach with demos that are really kind of cool. One of them is a gyroscope. Just bear with me. Angular momentum has two qualities, a magnitude and a direction. In conservation of angular momentum, both magnitude and direction of rotation are conserved. This is what makes tops stay upright when spinning for so long. It's kind of cool and pretty intuitive.
The next student we talked to was Victoria Beckinsale. At the top of her class, her story is even more alarming than the last. Hi, how are you?
I'm good. It's weird to be able to finally talk about this.
All right, let's get right down to it. When you first brought your story to the police, the nation was shocked. Can you recap what happened?
It all started with the king's crown. It's my fault. I must have miscalculated something.
But fortunately, this is an AP class, so you know, I'm testing for the AP test. You know, 99% of the time, the crown is not gold. You know, but in all my 15 years of teaching, I have never, ever, ever seen it be gold on an AP test. However, you know, I said 99%, so there could be that 1% where it actually is gold. But yeah, usually it's not. So you know, when you see it on the AP, you know, even if you have no idea what to write for the problem, you know, just write no. By giving this problem, I was simply trying to demonstrate Archimedes' principle, which says that the buoyant force on an object is going to be equal to the weight of the fluid displaced by the object. It's kind of counterintuitive. Objects with a greater volume have greater buoyancy. Archimedes was asked to find out if a king's crown was made of pure gold, and he did so by calculating its density through finding the volume with water displacement. He got the idea when he got into his bathtub and noticed that the water level rose. He then ran through the streets of his town naked, shouting Eureka. It's kind of cool if you ask me.
The third student we talked to was Dexter Watson, a student who feels his story reveals Schmidt's true character.
Help, I have done it.
Dexter, oftentimes when we hear your story, you say that Peter Schmidt singled you out. Can you please explain that?
Well, it all started with the compasses.
What? What started with the compasses?
Every time, I got the one.
I'm sorry, what do you mean by that?
Every time we handed out compasses, it happened.
With a compass, one end of the needle is magnetized, and that end always aligns itself with the Earth's magnetic field. With the compasses in my class, the right end is always magnetic, and the white end points in the opposite direction. Dexter always happens to get the nifty compass where the white end is magnetic, and he always ends up standing in the opposite direction of the other kids when we play musical compasses. Every year, I ask the Board of Ed for two things, $1 million mass spectrometer and a new compass. And every year, they turn me down, so we're just stuck using a program, and one student's gonna have the faulty compass.
The final student to come forward with her story was Trish Delta. Trish, although most stories are alarming, yours seems to be the most controversial. Can you recap for us what happened?
Honestly, like, it's really disturbing. Like, I don't know if I can talk about it.
This is a safe place. You can talk about it.
You really want to know?
Yes, please share with America what happened. What did Peter Schmidt do to you?
All right, well, Mr. Schmidt rubbed his magnet all over my flash drive.
Is that code for something?
No, he just rubbed it all over my flash drive.
Trish, I'd like you to point to me on this flash drive where Mr. Schmidt rubbed his magnet.
It was like right there where it opens.
This is alarming. Trish, can you go into a little bit more detail about what happened?
Yeah. Hey, my name is Trish Delta, and I'm an AP Physics with Mr. Schmidt. I run not one, not two, but three parallel circuits at the same time, because I got it like that. This one time, ran up to Mr. Schmidt with my flash drive. And I was like, yo, Mr. Schmidt, you're helping with my flash drive. And he started rubbing his magnet all over the place. And I was like, what the flux? I was like, what the flux, Mr. Schmidt? What are you doing? But it's cool, little shouter, don't
be so alarmed. I learned the brood. Whoa, whoa, now that's a bunch of bugaboo. Trisha had a question on magnetism and electric fields, which are pretty damn impressive. Data is stored on a flash drive by changing the location of electrons within it. An electric field from the computer can be applied to the flash drive in order to erase this data. However, a magnet also has the ability to scramble the direction of the charges within the flash drive, therefore corrupting the data. From now on, I'm just going to knock off, stop teaching, and give her a problem set.
With all this compelling evidence, it becomes hard to ignore the various accusations. But ultimately, it is up to each individual and what they believe. For now, what goes on in that classroom in H Hall will remain a mystery. This has been the E True Hollywood Story of Peter Schmidt.